Hey guys, and welcome back to Cityscape Brewing. I'm Dennis. Today, it's early in the morning in the summertime, which is the best time to brew. We're gonna be brewing up today a Vienna Lager, which is a great alternative to a fall beer, like a Marzen Oktoberfest or some other pumpkin beer. A Vienna Lager is similar to a Marzen. It's just got a little bit more bitterness to it and uses some different malts. We're gonna go through what the difference between those are and why this is a great fall beer after you guys hit that like and subscribe button, grab yourself a beer, or if it's early, a different kind of brew, and let's get after it. Also, if you wanna get these videos early and get some exclusive recipes, you can do that by joining as a channel member. You get some exclusive perks, recipes, and other things that channel members get for being awesome. So hit that join button below and become a member. So like I said before, the Vienna Lager is very similar to a Marzen style beer like an Oktoberfest. They were both created about the same time in the 1840s, and traditionally most of those beers around that time were a little bit darker. And the reason is because the malters didn't perfect how to make that pale malt yet, and some of the malt actually started becoming burnt in some areas and not dry enough in others because it was kind of direct flame. Later in the years, they would perfect how to make pale malt because it would have indirect heat using the dry air from that heating process, and that produced a lighter pale malt, which would be used in pale ales and eventually in pilsners. But around this time frame, the Vienna Lager and the Marzen were coming along, and there are a couple different characteristics that set them apart. So a Marzen will have a slightly higher ABV of around 6%, where a Vienna Lager is dropped back to about 5%. The Vienna Lager is a little bit more dry and a little bit less malty flavor, and that's partially because of that Vienna malt itself, which tends to be toffee, bready flavor, while the Marzen is a more rich malt and toasty flavor. Marzens were traditionally brewed in the spring and then aged through the summer, and that's why they were released around Oktoberfest, and it was a popular beer at that time, where Vienna Lagers were brewed year-round. This style isn't commercially found very often, and it's usually not called a Vienna Lager. In some cases, the most common ones that you'll be able to pick up at the store would be Modelo Negra, Sam Adams Boston Lager, and Yuengling. So let's get straight to the recipe. For this one, we're using, of course, Vienna malt. Along with that, we're using 3 pounds of Pilsner. We're gonna be using about 1 pound of dark Munich malt, and then we're gonna be rounding that off with 3/4 of a pound of Crystal 80 malt. To help with that pH in our mash, I am adding about 1/4 pound of acidulated malt, but you could be adding lactic acid to your mash as well if you don't have that on hand to drop that pH in the desired range of about 5.3. We're gonna be mashing this beer at about 149 degrees. That's gonna keep it a little on the drier side than a typical Marzen, which I would do at about 152 or 154. That'll give it more of that maltier flavor, right? So the lower in the temperature of your mash, the drier the beer, and vice versa. I'm also gonna be adding 4 grams of ascorbic acid into the mash. That's gonna help preserve that beer. It'll help scrub out any oxidation. I add that to most of my beers, especially lighter beers, which has helped a ton. For hops, we're just using 2 different varieties. I'm gonna be using 1/2 ounce of Northern Brewer hops for that bittering. And then we're gonna be adding Saaz hops towards the end at about 15 minutes. That's gonna give it around 23 to 25 IBUs, which is perfect for this style of beer. At about 15 minutes, we're also gonna be adding a Wurflock tablet, which will help clarify your beer and will help speed up that separation of proteins and make clear beer at the end of the day. For the yeast, we're actually doing something kind of special. We're repitching the Trub from our Pilsner that is fermenting currently. That one's cold crashed. We're gonna be taking the Trub from that one, pouring it into a different fermenter, and we're gonna be pitching right on top of that. I'm actually doing a separate video on how to do that, and if you wanted to, how to wash that yeast, I'll have those things linked in the video description below. But reusing yeast is a super awesome idea because it really uses healthy yeast cells that are active and ready to go. It'll start that fermentation process with an abundant number of cells and healthy, happy yeast. So just like other lagers, we're gonna need to let this one ferment out for a little while. It's gonna take about 1 week or so to do the first fermentation phase. We're gonna let it condition for a little while raising it up for a diacetyl rest to help eat off that leftover diacetyl, which is generally present with lager yeasts. And then we're gonna let that cold crash for a little bit before we keg it and condition it in the lagering phase, which is about 6 weeks. So after all that, we're gonna go ahead and come back and taste this thing, see how we did, and it'll be a perfect time to have this on tap for a perfect fall beer. And just like that, it's been 6 weeks and we're ready to taste our Vienna Lager. I'm super excited, so let's pour one and get after it. I give you the Vienna Lager. And the first thing that you're gonna notice is how crystal clear and absolutely awesome this color is. It is a nice amber color like it should be for that Vienna style. And it is super, super clear. And that really, really helps from the lagering phase by giving it time for all that stuff to crash to the bottom and make that crystal clear beer. It's got that also off-white, nice head on the top, and it sticks around for quite a while after you've poured it. So that's amazing. And let's go in for some smells. So right away you get some of those kind of toffier, maltier notes, but it's not overpowering. And maybe a little bit of hop characteristic, but it's not really not that much as it shouldn't be for this style. But most importantly, let's go in and see how it tastes. Wow, that is a nice, crisp, clean, delicious beer. You get that kind of dry aftertaste, but you still get those sweeter notes from the Vienna malt and some of that Munich malt that we put in there. Vienna malt has those distinct flavors like baked bread, hazelnut, caramel, and even honey flavors. And so you get a little bit of that sweetness, but then it's a dry, clean finish with just the right amount of bite in the background. I could have maybe added just a little bit more for IBUs to get a little bit more of that kind of hoppy flavor, but that's me personally. I think to style, this is probably very, very close to what it really should taste like as a Vienna Lager. And so there's not probably much I would change, if anything, on this beer so far. That is a fantastic beer and one that you're gonna drink all fall, because for those who are drinking Oktoberfests like Marzen's, you're gonna have pumpkin beers, you're gonna have all those things on the store shelves. But what they don't have a ton of is these Vienna Lagers. So go ahead and impress your friends and make an awesome fall beer that's gonna knock their socks off and one that you're gonna keep coming back to again and again. So as always, I'm gonna have this recipe in the video description below, but go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button as it helps the channel a lot, and ask any questions in the comment section. You know that's what this channel is all about, is helping you guys become better brewers. So with that, happy brewing and cheers. Hey, thanks for watching my video. You're awesome. You wanna be even more awesome? Hit that join button and become a member. You'll get exclusive members-only recipes and other perks like Brew Day sheets, and watch my videos early as they drop before anyone else. So hit that join button below, become a member, and be awesome.